But within these 4 or 5 years, the millibug is the main insect of the cotton pest. Why? Internal genetical changes in the plant body. The acceptors are introduced so that the millibug can be invited to destroy the cotton crop by means of the genetic engineering. Productivity of the crop is reducing continuously. Monsoon is coming late, going late. Monsoon is reaching the Himalayas. It was the reaching time at 15th July in the past. Now monsoon is taking to reach the Himalayas, 15 August. Monsoon was going back from India, 15th October. Now monsoon is delayed to go back up to 15 November also. And the impact of that incoming, ongoing monsoon delay timetable, the kharif crop is destroyed and rabi crop also is destroyed. There is a great impact of the monsoon deviations on the crop in entire world. Because global warming and climate change. There was one, my servant, Chindu Kevat, 70-year-old person at that time in my childhood. 100 kg bag was lifting very easily. 100 kg bag. Easily. Now this young generation here having 18-year-old, 24-year-old, they are unable to lift only 10 kg bag. Because infertility. Reason, global warming, climate change. This disturbance in the nature. Loss of the immunity. It has happened. In 15 October, 15 October, the winter was started in the past. And it's severe cold in central India. Temperature at Nagpur, my Vidarbha, coming down up to 2 degrees also sometime in November, in December. Now you see in entire India, today, 28th of the November, there is no cold, fans are coming, again, ACs, climate is totally changed. That means, those crops who are having specific intensity of the solar light, they are not getting ultimate. Production is reduced. Those crops which want specific cold plate, they are not getting, the production is decreased. This impact is given by the climate change, responsible global warming. The glaciers are melting continuously. I have seen in Kerala, the fishers' huts were 100 kilometers away toward the sea coast. Within these 30 years, they have shifted the huts away to the sea level, 1 kilometer. The big land is captured by the sea level. Because the sea level is increased, because ice is totally melting continuously. The glaciers are melting continuously. And in one day, entire Mumbai will be submerged in the water, sea water. Even Chennai, Kolkata will be submerged in the sea water. Even your Vijayawada, Vishakhapatnam, some part of the Vishakhapatnam, and coastal cities will be submerged in the sea water. Shanghai, New York, big cities, huge cities will be submerged in the water, and all the people will migrate to this Hyderabad city. What will be the situation in Hyderabad city? All these problems are created not by nature. Global warming is not created by the nature. Climate is not changed by the nature. These problems are created by the human being, their activities, and so-called development process. So-called development process. Western type of the development. Sathyo. These greenhouse gases are responsible for the global warming. Because these greenhouse gases are destroying the ozone layer, no doubt. But these greenhouse gases are absorbing the heat, incoming heat, from the sunlight. And outgoing heat from the earth, they are absorbing the heat. And so, the atmospheric temperature is increased. Atmospheric temperature is increased continuously by absorbing the incoming heat and outgoing heat. Now, the global temperature is increased only by 0.7 degrees centigrade. And there is a great impact of the hazardous impact of the living being, on the living being and natural resources of the global and climate change. And when the temperature will be increased up to 1.5 degrees centigrade, entire natural resources will be destroyed. None of the human being can survive in that stage. And within 18 years, that point we can reach. For the increase in temperature, by me means of the 1.5 degree centigrade, we have to emit 60,000 crore metric ton of the greenhouse gases. 60 crore metric ton of the greenhouse gases, 60,000 crore of the metric ton of the greenhouse gases we have to emit. And in 2013, entire industrial sector of the world has emitted in the atmosphere 3,600 crore metric ton of the greenhouse gases in 2013. I have not taken the greenhouse gas emission through the agriculture sector. I have not counted it. We will discuss later on. That means within 18 years, that point we can achieve. When the 1.5 degree centigrade will be increased, entire climate will be changed. And drought will become severe drought. Entire Rayalaseema and 60% of the Andhra Pradesh area and maximum area of the Telangana will become desert area. I have seen in Maharashtra. There is a rain shadow area because of the Western Ghat. In the past, only 4 districts of the Marathwada were included in rain shadow area. Usmanabad, Aurangabad, Jalna and Bid. Now within these 3 years I have seen the main part of the Latur, some part of the Hingoli, Nanded and Parbhani was submerged by rain shadow area. Last year entire Marathwada was occupied by the rain shadow area. There is no rain in Marathwada since 2 years. The high rainfall area, Nanded, Parbhani and Hingoli, there is no rain since 2 years. The Vidarbhas, Buldhana was not in rain shadow area. Last year I have seen Buldhana Akola also is occupied by the rain shadow area. That means within 2-3 years, entire Maharashtra will be occupied by the rain shadow area. As like your Telangana. What will be the situation in the future? How we can survive? How our future generation will be survived? This is a big challenge. This is a big challenge. Satyu, we have to change the attitude to solve these challenges. These greenhouse gases, so many greenhouse gases are responsible for global warming. Main 4 gases are responsible. Carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, methane, and chlorofluorocarbon, CFC gas. New generation of the chlorofluorocarbon, that is SCFC, hydrochlorofluorocarbon, it is the new generation of them. This CFC gas emitted by luxurious lifestyle. When you burn, you take the bath in the AC, you eat in AC, you sleep in AC, you walk in AC, and you die in AC. These luxurious people are responsible for emitting the CFC gas. Even trees, perfumes are responsible for CFC gas. But initial tree, carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, methane are emitted by 2 sectors. One industrial sector and second agriculture sector. When the industries are emitting huge quantity of the smoke, what are these greenhouse gases? They are going in the atmosphere, destroying the ozone layer, and the ultraviolet rays are coming and they are destroying the natural resources. The heat is increased, atmosphere is warming, and you are seeing hazardous impact. Solution to stop the industries. This is the real solution. This is the real solution. Can you accept? Nobody will accept. Because we have to increase the growth rate of economy. We are competing with China. But there is a great recession started in China now. Because there is a limit to consumerization. Luxurious lifestyle, there is a limit. You can purchase 1 car, 2 cars. We can't purchase 10 cars. We can build up 1 house, 2 house. We can't build up so many houses. There is a limit. And that limit we have achieved. Human being has achieved that limit. We can't grow the growth rate of Indian economy above that limit. So there is a great recession in the entire world economy today because of the saturation of the commodities. On other side, agriculture sector is also responsible for global warming and climate change. Mainly, chemical farming, green revolution, and organic farming is more responsible for global warming and climate change. subject is not how to plant the seed material of the sugarcane. It is not the subject for today. How to cultivate the land, it is not the subject today. Nature is, subject is back to nature. And natural way of life. This is the subject. Everybody know how to plant the plant material of the sugarcane. Everybody know how to seed, sow the seeds of the crops. Everybody know. What will be your commitment to save the nature? That is the subject. Because you are the cream of the society. Salaries are not the attempt. Salaries are not the aims of the human being. Not at all. You can't eat the money. You can't eat the money if you are not getting the food material to eat. You may be an account in the Swiss banks, but you will die with the hunger if you are not getting the food. That is the subject. When you feed chemically grown fodder to the animal, cow, bullocks, buffaloes, and all other livestock animals, the dung and urine is degraded, and by the degradation of the dung and urine of those animals, huge quantity of the nitrous oxide is emitted in the atmosphere. Also, the methane and nitrous oxide, also carbon dioxide, also is emitted. Global warming is increased. Chemically grown fodder is also responsible for global warming. Those supporters of Green Revolution and Agricultural University, they have to listen very concentratedly here. When human being is eating chemically grown food, by means of the decomposition of the human excreta urine, maximum quantity of the greenhouse gases, including nitrous oxide and methane, carbon dioxide, is emitted. Chemical farming is responsible for global warming. When the industries of the inputs of chemical farming, maybe seed industry, chemical fertilizer industry, insecticide industry, tractor industry, inputs industry, they are emitting maximum quantity of the greenhouse gases by means of the smoke every day. Input industry of the chemical farming also a main source of the greenhouse gases which are emitted and global warming. Even the raw material to manufacture this chemical fertilizer, insecticide, and all other infrastructure, maybe tractors and instruments, that raw material industry also is emitting which quantity of the greenhouse gases by means of the smoke in the atmosphere. To build up this input industry of the chemical farming sector infrastructure, the bricks are required to build up the construction. The iron is required, cement is required, water is required, wood is required. All these are coming from the nature. Nature is totally destroyed. And this brick industry, cement industry, iron industry, steel industry are emitting huge quantity of the smoke in the atmosphere. Again, the emission of the greenhouse gases and global warming is increased. agriculture universities. To build up the infrastructure of the agriculture industries, they want also the huge quantity of the bricks, cement, and iron, that means steel and all other materials. This industry also is responsible for the emission of the greenhouse gases. Even agriculture universities, their campuses, input industry of the chemical inputs, they want electricity. And that maximum electricity is coming from thermal power stations by burning the coal. And when the coal is burned, huge quantity of the greenhouse gases by means of the smoke are emitted in the atmosphere, and global warming is increased. That means entire green revolution is responsible for global warming. Entire green revolution, chemical input, chemical farming sector is responsible. The Japanese method of rice cultivation, water is dumped in the crop continuously. The residues of the last crop is spoiled, and huge quantity of the methane is emitted, and methane is going in the atmosphere, and global warming is increased. Your rice cultivation is also, Japanese method is most responsible for global warming. Most responsible. Agriculture universities is the creator of the global warming problem. Even when you give the excessive water to the sugarcane crop, you are the creator of the methane. This is the one of the greenhouse gases which is emitted in large quantity. The respiration of the gas holostein also is the creator. Is the creator of the methane in large quantity. Chemical farming responsible. And on the side, organic farming also responsible. In chemical farming, these agriculture scientists are suggesting to the farmers to burn the biomass. And after harvesting of the sugarcane crop, after harvesting of the paddy and wheat crop, you will go, you and travel entire India, you will see. During this harvesting period, huge quantity of the smoke is emitted in the atmosphere because all the residues of the crop are burned. And these are the greenhouse gases. Huge quantity are emitted and global warming is increased. Agriculture university is the big creator, main creator of the global warming. Agriculture university, who has given this technology to the farmers. Now also they are giving the technology. There was my 4-day workshop at Himachal Pradesh, Solon Agriculture University. And governor of the Himachal Pradesh was sitting to listen my workshop for 4 days. Vice Chancellor of Agriculture, Dr. Thakur, was present to listen the workshop. All agriculture scientists were present, and farmers came from entire Himachal Pradesh. Openly, I asked one question to Agriculture University Vice Chancellor in front of the governor. Mr. Vice Chancellor, give the me answer. Whether by means of the chemical farming, the fertility of the soil is increased or decreased? 2 minutes, he has not given any answer. He was very calm, seeing on the ground, not toward me. Again, I ask question. Mr. Vice Chancellor, give me the answer because you are legally committed to the give the answer because you are getting the salaries from the people. Whether the fertility of the soil is increased or decreased? Mr. Palekar, fertility is decreased. Why you are promoting? Why you are promoting chemical farming to the farmer? If you know, every agriculture scientist knows that the by-means of the chemical farming fertility is decreased. Why they are promoting again and again? This is a question we have to ask the agricultural ministries, because they are legally committed to give the answer. They are getting the salaries and funds from the people of India, not the government of India. Government is collecting the funds given by the people, not the government of India. Sathiyo, organic farming also same responsible, I will say more responsible for global warming. How? I will verify. Because this is the main issue today. This today, we have to search out the solutions. We have to give the message to the world that we have the solution. We have the solution. This cow dung manure, FOM, in Kannada it is called tippe gobra. In Telugu it is called farmer manure ko kya kehte hain? Au peda. Deshwali au peda. Manure. When you spread out cow dung manure on the surface of the soil, farmer manure, when you spread out compost, vermicompost on the surface of the soil, there is a 46% carbon existed in the manure. Maybe a FOM, maybe compost, maybe vermicompost. And when the temperature is increased above than 28 degrees centigrade of the daytime atmosphere, the stable carbon which is existed in the FOM, compost, vermicompost, start to convert itself into unstable carbon. And when the temperature is started to increase above 36 degrees centigrade, this unstable carbon is converted itself into volatile carbon. Entire carbon is released, and that carbon is oxidized by the oxygen in the atmosphere, and by means of the carbon dioxide is emitted in huge quantity in the atmosphere. Huge quantity. And simultaneously, the methane and nitrous oxide are also emitted. That means organic farming is more responsible for the emission of the greenhouse gases and global warming and climate. Organic farming also responsible. Why you people are promoting organic farming? Why? Sathiyo, in Telangana, what is the temperature in March, April, May? 48 degree. In Hyderabad, 48 degree. Agar Switzerland ka koi aadmi gora waha ka 0 degree mein rehta hai pure saal, aur mai mahine mein dopahar ko 2 baje Hyderabad ke khuli dhoop mein usko kapde nikal kar khada kiya jaye to uska omelet ban jayega. Itni dhoop, too much temperature. And you are applying the vermicompost, compost and cow dung manure in May. Is it correct? April, May? Entire carbon is emitted. Organic farming is more dangerous than chemical farming, because maximum greenhouse gases are emitted by, carbon is emitted by organic farming. Sathiyo, the humus in the soil is the main absorber of the heat. The humus in the soil is the main absorber of the heat because it is constituted by only carbon. 60% carbon existed in the humus, and 6% nitrogen existed. Carbon nitrogen ratio is 10:1. And that humus is totally destroyed by the chemical and organic farming. Organic farming is a main cause of destruction of the humus. Organic farming is a pre-planned conspiracy to restrict the humus creation in the soil. And if there is no humus in between two soil particles, immediately in the evening, the soil, our soil become cold. Become cold. Because the heat is not conserved in the soil particles. There is no humus. That means excessive heat from the atmosphere, the soil was conserving, that phenomena is totally stopped by means of the organic farming. When carbon dioxide is emitted, it remains 120 years. It is not destroyed for 120 years. When methane is emitted, it remains in the atmosphere for 20 years. 20 times more hazardous than carbon dioxide. Methane is 20 times more hazardous. Nitrous oxide remains in the atmosphere for a long period. And they destroy ozone layer, and ultraviolet rays are coming and destruction of the natural system. If the government of India has given legal commitment in Copenhagen summit to reduce 23% carbon emission, how? There is a question. How? If they want to fulfill their commitment to reduce the 20%, 23% carbon emission, they have to ban chemical farming. They have to ban chemical farming. They have to ban organic farming at once. Then they can fulfill the commitment. They have to stop the industries which are not essential at all. Then they can fulfill the commitment. There is no alternate at all. They have to come to decision at one. They have to stop the chemical farming and organic same time. They have to ban. What is the alternate? Zero budget natural farming. In our zero budget natural farming, no single gram of the greenhouse gas is emitted. No single gram of the greenhouse gas. Because we are not burning the biomass. We are not burning the residues of the crops. We are utilizing all the residues of the crop as a mulching in between two lines on the surface of the soil. So no problem, no emission of the greenhouse gases at all. In chemical farming and organic farming also, the farmers are purchasing truckload of the FOM from the market, from another farmers. And they are creating so many problems because FOM also, farm-made manure also, cow dung manure also, is responsible for the constipation to the soil. Farm and manure is responsible for the creation of those so many problems in the soil and the plant body. Even the cow dung manure is also creating the heat in the soil in maximum quantity. So to utilize the cow dung manure is not a natural process also. It is not a natural process. So in my technology, zero budget natural farming, we are not purchasing single gram of the FOM, cow dung manure, from the market. No single gram of it. We are not utilizing the cow dung manure as a manure in the zero budget natural farming. We have stopped the creation and emission of the greenhouse gases on the spot. We are not utilizing compost, vermicompost. We are not emitting greenhouse gases at all. We are not utilizing any chemical fertilizer, micronutrient in zero-budget natural farming. We are not purchasing any chemical insecticide and fungicides. We are not utilizing tractor thermal for cultivation also, because in orchard and sugarcane there is no cultivation. That means zero-budget natural farming is the ultimate solution to stop the emission of the greenhouse gases. Ultimate solution.